You actually mentioned some very good things about what community policing should do for this country when you were, should have done when you were introducing the program in the country. That is bring the police more closer with the people, because you said the police at the time were very much focused on crime prevention and being so hard on criminals and forgetting to get much closer to the community and the people. But right now, I don't know if you would say that program worked, because until to date, we see elements of police brutality, and many people have raised alarm over, you know, how police, the Uganda police, actually handles the public. And in videos, you see, when you get arrested, somebody's just grabbed, even if they're criminal, and, you know, bundled into the, you know, under that pickup, and you sleep in there, and they drive you to wherever, I think, the police station. The most recent incident was over the arrest of Sheikh Kamoga. You saw how the policemen came and the beatings that happened in that home when they were, you know, arresting this gentleman. We saw students going on the streets and being roughed up when they were trying to, the intern doctors, when they were trying to go to meet the speaker and, you know, present their grievances. And people are like, no, this is not how the police should be handling the public. They actually have a duty to just walk these people, let's say in terms of a demonstration, or you want to go and present your grievance to the speaker. They must give you the security, walk you there, make sure that you don't disrupt other people, you get there safely, and then you go back safely. You don't even need permission to do that. But we see police saying you haven't asked for permission, there are beatings. Would you say your community policing program worked with all that kind of brutality that we're still seeing in us?
First of all, I would want to say that the community policing program from 1994 worked. We, if you look at the annual police crime reports, police annual crime reports, you will be able to find that each and every year there is an improvement in terms of the way police sort of the way they solve the crime. In some cases, if you take something like a 20-year period of time, and maybe recently 15 years period of time, because if you start a program, it doesn't produce the results there and then. But if you look at the last 15 years, we'll be able to see exponentially drop in the crime rate. And if you read those reports very well, one of the factors contributing to the reduction in crime is community policing. It is reported there, it is recorded, and it's true. Why? Because people are able to call the police when they think a crime is about to take place. People are able to call the police when a crime has just taken place. Now, let's come to a reaction to the report, a different matter. Okay, but that the people can call the police that something has taken place there is something to celebrate about, because they were not even calling. Remember at one time, what we call just, you know, mob justice was too much. Every small thing, somebody would be beaten. Would be killed. So you can say that community policing is something to celebrate, okay? Community policing also helps the kind of officers that you are going to get from the community. I joined the police where the thought of that I had joined the police, people from my village, I mean my father's friends, they went to him and said, "Omwana yagwa,
eh?
Did your son fail at Makerere University? Okay? Why has he joined the police?" Now, They thought that the people who are joining the police should be people who failed in school, people who are stealing chicken, matoke. So the LCs and the people who were in charge there would say, send so-and-so's son to the police. The police will put him right for us who have failed him. Mm. But now, it is not about lack of jobs, but I can tell you that even the interest in joining police by young people in Uganda is something that has come out from the way our officers go and talk in universities about themselves, about the police, what is required of a police officer. That interaction, that kind of partnership has improved the interest, probably, of the right people to come to the police. Now, the kind of the police that we have, we should accept that we have a law, Public Order Management Act. It exists. It clearly states what police should do and what management, managers of events, of political activities should be able to do. There were obnoxious sections within that. Now, after the Chivumbi, those Chivumbi, you remember when he successfully, there are some sections. Was it section 41? I'm not sure about that. Can be checked very well. They were removed, asking for permission and that kind of thing. However, I know there are altercations between the police. We don't have manpower. You told us late. You did this and this and this. You did this and this and this. Those are happening. They do not take away the fact that community policing has helped in reduction of crime, in investigations of crime. That fact will not take it away. I think we should now focus on how do the police, okay, respect more of the rights and freedoms of people, even when these are political rights. And I'm one of the people who say that, please, even though you don't agree on whether you should go to see the speaker, whether you should go to parliament, whether you should stand here with your placards, even when that happens, then you need to explain to the people without recourse to brutality. You remember, if you go and read my tweet, when Sheikh Kamoga, when the police went there, in the beginning I didn't know what had taken place there, but later on I saw the video on social media. You remember what I tweeted?
What did you tweet? You tell us.
Yes, I said that this is not, I said that those young people who were arrested, okay, at best are witnesses. And they are victims, isn't it? If they are victims, rescue the victims first. After you have rescued the victims, these are even going to be your witnesses. Now, if you harass them, if you beat them, if you whatever, how is this person who has been brutalized going to give you a statement, a witness statement against the people that you think were victimizing them? So I said, whatever happened is not good. That one, I talked about it, okay? So I think we should be able to delineate community policing. That is part of community policing, by the way. However, that it does not take away the fact that community policing has really helped in the reduction of crime. We can do better.